Right, so remember, with breaking down the kick, it's not where the ball's going, it's about how high you can get it from the ground. Hey, welcome back to Dallas Sports. If you previously watched the box kicking video we've made last time, I've spoken about three important things. What you could do or what you could try out that will improve your kicking, box kicking. Point number one was always make sure you've got a good grip, fingers spread. The second point was the release of the ball. It's got to be consistent, nice and still. And the third point was to make sure you've got a good connection. So in this video, I'm gonna pick up the ball off a ruck, just like in a game situation. So keep watching. So before we get into it, don't forget to hit that bell for notifications and also like, subscribe, and please share. So here we go. This is the ruck, so where the ball is gonna be. Okay, and this is the first defender around the fringes, guard. So normally you would have a guard placing there. You've got a bodyguard or a second defender, and you've got a third defender, the C. So this is a defensive line, trying to put line speed on. What you'd normally have, okay, the key thing is not to rush. You have to set yourself. So we're gonna pick the ball up, and then we're gonna have to step away from the ruck. Okay, so that's key. Point number one, okay, you can maneuver the ball inside, sole, outside, or laces. Try to adjust the ball in the direction where you kick it. Okay, so the first one would be set yourself before you touch the ball with your hands. You know where you're going, hips facing in the kicking direction, shoulders facing in the kicking direction, not the touch line, because then we're gonna have to come around. All right, remember? So from here, there's the seam, palm of my hand on the seam, nice big grip. When I pick the ball up, the ball's gonna go in line with my kicking leg, but I'm gonna step there with my inside foot, and then the ball's gonna be released more or less on the cone, in line with the cone as well. Okay, so from my hip, just from here to there. Remember, it's foot to ball, and we're not kicking around, we're kicking up. Okay, this is what it should look like. From here to there. Balance, good balance is important. Okay, because if you're not stable, it's easy for you to fall to the side, and that will affect the kick. Okay, so another thing, you can implement a football, because it's really nice to kick a football, especially from underneath, so that you can get used to the feeling. All right, the sound and the feeling is very important. How many times do you make contact with the ball and you know immediately that's not a good connection or that's not a good kick? Okay, so it's important to practice getting the ball on the sweet spot of your foot. So it's good to practice with a football, okay? Nice steps, can you hear the sound? That's lower foot, that's sweet spot. See that sweet spot? Just keep practicing to get that consistency. A lot of times, we focus where the opposition are, the guard, bodyguards, and not really where the kick is happening. So you've got to learn to shift your focus. Okay, you've got so much time. Nowadays, the ref will even tell you, use it. So you've got so much time, there's no need to rush yourself. Okay, so it's very important for any dads watching this that would like to help out their sons at home, whatever your age, 12, 13, 14 years and up, it's important that you set yourself, be relaxed, take a deep breath, and then you become the kick. Okay, I'm gonna do this again, especially if there's threat there. Okay, so you set yourself, remember it's from here to there, from here to there, with good balance, okay? The next point, obviously, how do you get maximum height without forcing it? Now, the key is, remember what I said, bottom third's the sweet spot on the ball. Okay, it's foot to ball, you're kicking straight up. Okay, but a lot of times you kick it too hard, and then what happens? the ball doesn't even travel further than 5 meters. But here's the key. I'm gonna run it through and then you try it out and let me know if it works for you. Check it out. Tell me what you think. Okay, so the next part of it, I'm gonna explain to you, how do you practice to get maximum height? This is also the breakdown of it. You're not gonna go there and then step and then kick. Okay, your foot really close. Foot really close. Okay. From here, as you can see, the ball's underneath my left, my inside shin. Right? So my movement from here is straight up. Now I can rush this kick and I can still be accurate if I have a good connection. Okay, remember, foot to ball. So from here to there. Okay, in a split second. Check it out. Right, so remember, we're breaking down the kick. It's not where the ball's going, it's about how high you can get it from the ground. Okay, okay, so the next one is obviously when you pick the ball up. Okay, the plan was to go from here to there, but what if you just want to dink it over? This is a very important kick to lean back, keep your balance. Check it out. So from here to there, okay, from here to there. Right, so if you really like that, please like, subscribe and share and hit that bell. This is the simple drills that have been broken down to help you out. Okay, watch out for more. There's a lot more coming your way. Thanks for the support. Cheers.